Session of the Commerce Club in the academic year 2021-22. The Commerce Club in the Samhita Academy will enable students to improve their self-confidence, build a proactive approach, and increase their financial literacy. Proposed activities include guest lectures from eminent professionals in the field of finance, marketing, psychology, etc., business quiz, case study analysis, elocution, and many more activities are in the pipeline. Before we begin, I would like to take this opportunity to invite our principal, Ms. Jyoti, to address the gathering.
Good morning, everybody, my dear children, teachers, and a very warm good morning to our special guest, Mr. Milind Nair.
And good morning, ma'am.
So glad, sir, that you accepted our request for the inaugural of this club. This is the first session. This was our dream, something that we envisioned in 2019, and we wanted to get started in 2020. Unfortunately, the circumstances did not permit, but we were very determined that we are not going to let go of this opportunity, and we are going to get started this year. Like Suraj mentioned at the beginning, that there is an intention, a very clear intention and a purpose for this club. And as you know, students study commerce, there is a lot of theory that you're studying. But we at Samhita, we don't want you to go out of Samhita just being exemplary at your theoretical practices. We would want you to have that exposure, have insights into the real world, which is waiting for you after 12th standard. And we would want you to make the best use of this opportunity that is available. That's the way forward. I wish everybody all the very best. May this club flourish. And that would happen with the contribution and complete involvement of all the students. The teachers are very enthusiastic. And I'm sure all the guests that we invite, they are also participating very enthusiastically, giving their precious time to be here. But now it's up to you, students, to make the best use of this opportunity and carry this club forward on your shoulders with your responsible behavior and your complete involvement. Wishing the Commerce Club all the very best. Thank you. Thank you for the invite today. I'm so happy to be here.
Thank you, Jyoti ma'am. To kickstart today's discussion, I would like to welcome our guest, Mr. Milind Nair, Deputy General Manager Finance at Bosch Limited. Mr. Nair is an experienced finance and project management professional and a certified chartered accountant with more than 20 years of experience in the industry. His hobbies include reading books, working out, and playing chess. With vast amounts of information, reading and understanding a business newspaper often seems overwhelming to many of us here. However, it is important to inculcate the habit of staying updated with the current affairs. To enlighten us on the process of reading a business newspaper, Mr. Nair has gathered with us today. I encourage you all to put forward your queries and ask relevant doubts to make this session an insightful one. A Q&A session will be held towards the end. Thank you, sir, for taking out the time, your valuable time to meet with us. Over to you.
Yeah, thanks, Suraj. So, you know, we are come from two different worlds. So you are people, students, professors, you know, theorists, and I am a practitioner. So I come with a little bit of fear when I am entering your world. Yeah. So for y'all giving presentations, listening, learning, and all is, you know, way of life. For us, it is more of practice. And then, you know, sometimes we get this opportunity to interact with students. For me personally, this is a rare occasion because I hardly have interacted earlier with students. I don't have any teaching experience. Of course, I am a practitioner, and I will try to give you some insights from the real world. Yeah. And I would also like to, you know, congratulate you for this initiative. Yeah, it's a brave initiative. Rather, in my, days of education, I have never come across, you know, any kind of initiative where, you know, you talk about a commerce club and then you call up people and then, you know, try to bridge the gap between the real world and the theory. Yeah, it's a brave initiative. Hats off for your courage. Yeah. Important thing is you have to sustain it. Yeah. In our corporate world, whenever we start something, we are always worried, you know, whether it will get sustained. Yeah. So let's see how we can start this, and I will try to give my best so that we can have a good beginning. From my end, I will try to make it as interesting as possible. Yeah. From your end, I would like to request you all, please do not let your mind wander. Yeah, it's a vast topic. 45 minutes is not enough. Yeah, I tried to kind of rehearse couple of times, but some of the topics are topics by itself. Yeah. So I will also try to see that I do not go into too much depth. Yeah, I'll try to keep it at a certain depth, because I understand that some of the terminologies will be quite new for y'all. But y'all are, you know, Google and Facebook and LinkedIn generation. So even if the terms are new, you can quickly Google and find out. That was a luxury in our times. So life is a bit easier for y'all. Yeah. So with that, I think we can start. Let me see if I have covered some of the things. Yeah. See, the overview of the presentation. The presentation is quite simple. Yeah. I don't want to go into all the, you know, the details right now, but I will start with an opening question. Yeah. So how many of y'all have a habit of reading any kind of newspaper, general newspaper? I'm not talking about business news. So you can put your hand so that I can get a feel of, you know, yeah, there is a habit in the population that I'm talking. If you can raise your hand, or you can, you know, digitally. Okay. I think I'm getting some responses. Yeah. Maybe 3 plus another 5 or around 10. And I think total is around 30, if I am not mistaken, the students. Yeah, what about the other, 20? I hope your computers are working. There is no problem. I hope on the family front, everything is okay, because this is an online, platform. So I have to ask all these questions. Because once I jump into the slides, I may not be able to see you as well. So it is all entirely up to how you interact, how you answer the questions and all that.
Maybe they're just being honest that they don't really read newspapers.
So then
that's a possibility.
Yeah, so people who are already reading, no problem. It's a good start. Yeah. People who don't have the habit of reading, maybe y'all are reading it through some apps. Yeah. For us oldies, it was a newspaper, and we never actually liked the apps. You know, now also when I read the apps, you see, it is apps are all headlines. Yeah. And in a mobile, you may be reading, you know, summarized news, but the depth of it is not there. So my suggestion, though it's a little old fashioned, still suggestion is please start reading newspaper. Yeah. If not business, start with general newspaper. Of course, you can directly jump into business newspaper. There is no constraint. Yeah. Okay. So the second question, again, this is just kind of an icebreaker. So feel free to talk your mind. Yeah. What do you think are the benefits of reading a business newspaper? So anybody can answer, you know.
Yes, Pranav. Would you like to share your inputs?
I guess that it helps you stay in touch.
Stay in touch. Okay. Anybody else?
Pushit, you also raised your hand. What about your inputs?
Oh, yes, ma'am. I think that it helps you keeping in track with the current affairs which is going on in the business world with other companies. And
yeah, very good. You are touched upon the right thing.
I saw Shruti also raised her hand. Shruti, your inputs? Okay, suppose she's unable to mute. Okay, what about you, Ninarika? What is your inputs about it?
Yeah, I can learn about what's going on in today's world, and it's easier to have conversations like with my dad and some people about what's going on.
So Ninarika, do you read a business newspaper?
No, a general newspaper which like covers everything.
Yeah, so in the general newspaper also you will see that there are a couple of pages dedicated to business news. Yeah, so those people who are reading general newspaper, they will have a flavor of, you know, what is written in the newspaper. So not necessary that you start with the business newspaper. You can get a summarized view of, even there are very good articles in the general newspaper. Yeah. So yeah, so with that I will start with the topic. We have around I think, ma'am, we have around 45 minutes. How is it?
Yes, we do.
Okay, so there will be some kind of spillover. Let's see how it goes. Yeah. So just let me share my screen. So just let me know when you're able to see my screen. Yeah.
Screen is visible, sir.
Okay. So the heading is quite obvious. Business newspaper reading, a useful habit to inculcate. Yeah. So we are talking about a habit. So what we are talking about is continuity. Yeah. Very important. Just keep this in mind. So why should we read a business newspaper? So see, this slide is actually in a mind map format. Don't think it is exhaustive. Yeah. What I have given is, you know, indicative reasons. So by no means is it exhaustive, but there is a lot of matter in this one slide. And please pay attention. Yeah. And in case there are some questions to be answered, you all can, you know, try your best in answering those questions. So yeah, in the role of students, yeah, now this is a specific question. In the role of students, why is the reading business newspaper important? So ma'am, if you can choose couple of students for the response on this question.
Sure, sir. So what about you, Akul? Would you like to share inputs? Can you mute yourself and speak?
Oh, I think for students, I think it will be helpful for, like, for interviews, and the interviewers ask questions about the current affairs, we can be updated with that.
Very good.
Aman, what about you? Would you like to share inputs as well? Okay, I'll pass it over to Jane then. Can you just share inputs, Jane?
Ma'am, I think it's important to read business newspapers to be in track with what's going on in the world.
Yeah, very good. It's a kind of an overarching answer, but it touches on the key aspect. Yes. Anybody else, or I can jump into, you know, the details of it.
Nivedita, we did not hear it from you as well.
This is a little bit more specific, but like, I'm a student and I feel like if you start investing in stuff earlier on, then you can build like a kind of nest egg. But the thing is, you need to have a lot of background business information to do that. So I feel like reading newspapers every day would help build that.
So you're talking about stocks, is it?
Yes, sir. But I don't know anything about it at all. So I realized that my knowledge is quite poor. And if I had read newspapers, then I would have probably built it up.
Yeah, it's actually, if you see business newspaper, half the population who read business newspaper, they skip everything else and go directly to the stock page. Yeah, because when it comes to motivation for grown-ups, money is a, you know, high motivating element. So though you will see some kind of politics, some geopolitical headlines and all that, directly people will jump into the stock page. Yes, it's a big motivator. Yeah, so moving on. So I'll start with a very basic thing. Yeah, see, for students, expanding vocabulary very important. When you read a business newspaper, there will always be some terms, some financial terms, which you must not have heard. Yeah, when you read it, when you Google it, you'll get the meaning out of it and your vocabulary will expand on the financial term. Then second part is that the level of language, the level of English language is always a little higher than a general newspaper. So you will learn some new English words. Yeah, and the usage of it. So this will help you all in expanding your vocabulary. Yeah, second point. Business awareness. There was already, I think, a couple of students have already talked about this, that it increases the business awareness. Now, what is business awareness from a student perspective? Yeah. For example, now you people are in 11th and 12th. Yeah. After 3 years, you all will complete, say, senior college, or 4 years, 3 or 4 years. And then some of you all would like to go and attempt some competitive exams or go for MBA. At that time, the expectation is, like, you know, there is a filtering process. So you have group discussions, then you have 1:1 personal interviews. In that, it is expected that you are aware about the general business. Yeah, not in depth, but at least you are aware of what is happening in India, what is happening in the world at a general level. Yeah. So it's a big competitive advantage for those students who start reading business newspaper early. Yeah, I have seen MBA students who don't know how to read business newspaper. Yeah, they try to read maybe 3 months before the interview, and they try to read all the articles. Yeah, newspaper reading is not novel reading or a book reading. It is a skill that you develop over a period of time, and this skill can be developed only when you read on a regular basis. It is not something that one fine day you pick it up and then you start reading cover to cover. So it's a skill, and skill gets developed over a period of time. It can't be developed overnight or 2 months or 3 months. Yeah. So very important for business awareness. Next point, speed reading. Again, a very important concept. Yeah. Students, you know, you must have seen a business newspaper. It is 14 to 16 pages. Yeah. Now, I am sure you are having a very active life. You all don't have the time to read 16 pages every day. Yeah. What you all have is 15 to 20 minutes maximum, and sometimes even less. Same is the case with me. Yeah. So 14 pages or 16 pages, time is 10 minutes. So within that 10 minutes, you have to choose what you want. Yeah. So again, it's a skill. So here also speed reading is very important. Again, it's a skill which is developed over a period of time. 16 pages browsing, 10 minutes time. What do you read? So many topics, so much information overload. How do you utilize that information for your own benefit? Big motivation, very important skill. Not only for your exams, not only for your academics, very important for your career, very important as a life skill. Yeah. Gaining information, maximum information in limited time. That is what is speed reading. But if you Google and if you go to the experts, it's a science by itself. So I'll not go into depth here. But you must have got the flavor of it. Yeah. So this I thought are the key takeaways for students. Yeah. So let's move on to the next role, professionals. Yeah. So now imagine that you are a professional. Now you all have done your chartered accountancy or cost accountancy, or you have become investment bankers or stock advisors or lawyers. Yeah. You all are professionals now. Either you have joined the corporate world or you all are starting on your own. So what do you get from the business newspaper? First is specialized knowledge. So if you are a chartered accountant or a cost accountant or a company secretary, you will gravitate towards the financial statements, the IPO advertisements, the notices, yeah, the AGM notices. This is what you will see first, because you all have that knowledge. People who are not professionally qualified, yeah, and they have a general knowledge, they will not look at that also because they don't understand. Yeah. So this is the power of knowledge. More knowledge, more awareness of what to read in the business newspaper. Managerial inputs. Now, what do you mean by managerial inputs? As a professional, we look up to, you know, senior leaders, how they are navigating their business. So if I take my own example, you know, I work in Bosch. It's an automotive company. So I will gravitate towards what is the automotive trend. Yeah. If there is an interview from the chairman of Maruti. So now Maruti is the biggest passenger car manufacturer, almost 50% market share. So what he says has a weightage. So if he says that, okay, the demand is not up to the mark, or demand is fluctuating. Yeah. Or most recently, supply chains are fluctuating because of chip shortage. So you will be surprised to know that in your motor car, there are more software and electronic components than mechanical. So a chip shortage impacts the manufacturing of a car. Yeah. So all these managerial inputs from the various leaders we will get, and we will use it to navigate our own business, manage our own company, interact with the vendors, the customers. So all these managerial inputs we'll get from the business newspaper. Next point, business acumen. Very important concept. Please pay attention. Business acumen is making effective business decisions. making effective business decisions, simple one line sentence, but the background of it is you should have knowledge. Knowledge of what? You should have knowledge of how to make money. Yeah. When I say how to make money, you should have knowledge of revenue streams. You should have knowledge of cost streams. You should have knowledge of product lines. You should have knowledge about competitors, how those competitors are competing against you in the market. What are their product lines? So there is an entire series of things on which you should have knowledge. Based on that, based on your specialized knowledge, based on your managerial inputs, you synthesize and then you come with an effective business decision. So that is business acumen. So children, when you all progress from an entry level job to a mid level job to a senior level job, more and more in the corporate world, they look at you and ask you whether you have the business acumen. How do you gain this business acumen? You don't gain the business acumen just by reading some books, by reading the being good at academics. You inculcate a habit of reading business newspaper year on year, day on day, absorbing stuff and using that stuff at the appropriate moment. Very important. So please take care of this. If you all want to go into corporate world, reading business newspaper as early as possible will be helpful. Coming to entrepreneurs. I know that many of you all are students of entrepreneurship. So here I will request ma'am if couple of students can give their responses why reading business newspaper is important for entrepreneurs.
Sure, sir. I would like just give me one moment, sir. Sania, is there in the classroom? I suppose not. Okay. Vidula, would you like to share inputs?
Yes, ma'am. So I think it's important for entrepreneurs to read like Business Standard paper because the business environment is very dynamic. So they need to keep themselves like updated about the change in like trends and product lines so that they can improvise their product in such a way.
Very good. Actually, very good insight. Anybody else?
Poshit, would you like to go?
Yes, ma'am. Pretty much the same as what Vidula said. As an entrepreneur, you would like to see what are the trending things which are trending in the market. So in case you are planning to do a business, you can see what are the interviews or what are the other entrepreneurs who are like a very professional type of people. So how they go through the business, what are their daily things which they do, so that it keeps having an insight on that.
Good. Actually, you used a very important word, trend. Yeah. I will explain this further in detail. Yeah. Anybody else?
Sanya? Oh, she just left. So I think we are done.
Yeah. So, both the students have, touched upon some very key aspects. And I would like to elaborate on that. Yeah. So, I think the first student talked about business environment. Very important when it comes to entrepreneurship. What is business environment for an entrepreneur? It covers a lot of things. You can gain knowledge about competition. Yeah, you can gain knowledge about market. You can gain knowledge about trends. You can gain knowledge about industry. You can gain knowledge about companies. Yeah, all this put together along with economic policy, government policy, globalization, all this put together is the business environment. Yeah. And we have to navigate through this environment. Sometimes there is a recession. Sometimes there is a boom. Sometimes there is fear in the market. All this, is part of the environment. Environment is something that cannot be controlled by us. But we know what to do if we can anticipate what is the entire environment. Yeah, we know what it is. Like in the winters, we wear woolen clothes. Yeah, we cannot stop winters, but we know how to navigate, how to react. Yeah, sometimes we can even anticipate. So that is the interesting part when it comes to business. Anticipation is worth its value in gold. If you can anticipate something before it happens, you can make a lot of money in the market. Yeah. So moving on. Business opportunities. Very important. Opportunities and entrepreneurship. No, entrepreneur means the first thing that should come in mind is opportunities. Yeah. See, in human psychology, we are made up to survive. Yeah. So our first reaction is to look at risks, how this will not happen. But entrepreneurs are a different breed. They look at opportunities where others think that those are problems. That is how they are always one step ahead. That is how they make money. Yeah. Again, a habit which needs to be developed. Yeah. And everybody is, at a different level when it comes to opportunity seeking. Some people can see opportunities which others can't. Yeah. Some people can see opportunity in a certain sphere which others can't. And why it happens? Because the base is built up good academics, good knowledge, good awareness. All this feeds into it. Otherwise, you cannot understand whether it's an opportunity or whether it is a problem. Yeah. So business opportunities. Again, I can talk a lot on this, but I'll move forward. Mega trends, very, very important. Children, if your mind has wandered, please come back. Somebody talked about trends. I'm talking about mega trends. If you all Google, yeah, later on you all can Google. Our life is shaped by mega trends. I'll give you an example. Yeah, there was a mega trend of Cold War between USA and USSR. It shaped millions of people's lives from 1945, end of World War, till 1990, till USSR disintegrated. Yeah. This is a mega trend which has impacted all the businesses, all the government policies across the world. Similarly, now we have a mega trend. What is the mega trend? Mega trend is something which goes on for 15 years, 20 years, 25 years. You have to catch that mega trend. If you don't catch that mega trend, sometimes you feel out of control, or sometimes you don't know what is happening. Yeah. Now the mega trend for the next 20 years, what I will tell you. Tussle between USA and China. It's a mega trend. Next 20 years, it will roll out. Why? Because in 1990, China was a less developed nation. Nobody talked about China. Now, China is a highly developed nation. It challenges US in many spheres. US is uncomfortable. They want to be at the top, but there is a challenger now. So there is a trade war. Trade war between US and China. When you read business newspapers, you will see articles, and these articles will repeat in some form or the other. Yeah, this I will explain further in the next slide. There is another mega trend. What is the mega trend? Green energy. Green energy, another 20, 25, 30, 40 years. Why? Global warming. Everybody knows. So green energy is a mega trend. Can you make money out of green energy? Mukesh Ambani is making it. In the AGM, what did he say? I will invest $10 billion so that I catch this mega trend, make a lot of money, I give back to the society. It's not that he's only making money, he's giving back to the society. How is he giving back to the society? Less fossil fuel, more of green energy. He has the biggest refinery in India or maybe in Asia. But he's moving his business. He's moving his business from fossil fuel we are burning to green energy. Why is he doing it? Because he knows this is a mega trend. It will not change. Trend, fashion trend changes every year. there is an intermediate trend, but when you catch hold of a mega trend, you know how to steer the business. You are anticipating. Anticipation, right anticipation is worth value in gold. Mukesh Ambani knows green energy, it's not going away. Pour money into it, reap benefits out of it. This is a mega trend. There is another mega trend, aging population and healthcare cost. Healthcare cost in US, 10 times more than in India. In India also it will come. Is it a mega trend? Yes, it's a mega trend, because better healthcare facilities, more people will live. More people consume fast food, end up more with illness in the old age. All this gets fed in into the mega trend. How do you make, how do you reap benefit? How do you not just reap benefit for yourself? How do you give back to the society? Pharma companies, hospitals, doctors, medicine. Yeah. This all gets lashed onto that mega trend. Moving on. Others. Now I have clubbed everything under others. It's a very vast field. I cannot give justice to this, but I'll just touch upon the certain aspects of it. Government policy. Again, massive area. How does government policy impact? Taxation policy, export-import policy, industrial policy, monetary policy. All these. So government is a very powerful player. Business always looks up at the government. What is the government doing? Whether it is pro-business or anti-business. The moment, years back, there was a communist government. Immediately, the stock market fell. Why the stock market fell? Communist government, they look at the downtrodden. They look at labor. These are the issues that they want to resolve. Again, I am nothing against the communists, but their focus shifts. Yeah, once the focus shifts, policies shift. When the policies shift, business environment gets impacted. Business environment gets impacted, your business gets impacted. So those are the linkages. Yeah. Social psychology. Children, you all must be having psychology as a subject. Please don't underestimate that subject. That subject is very, very important. How it is important from a business context, I will tell you. 2008, recession, fear in the market. Good stocks tumbling like there is no tomorrow. Don't know what will happen. People who don't understand social psychology sold off their stocks. 1.5 years down the line, stocks have given 300% return. Why? Because you have not understood the psychology of the market. When the market is in a fear, when markets are driven by fear, they overreact. Similarly, euphoria in the market. .com, 1999. Yeah. Invest anything on net, double the money. Yeah. Euphoria. In 2000, all kinds of fancy models have come. Yeah. People are saying brick and mortar, that's the end of it. Everything is online. This I'm talking about 20 years back. All kinds of fancy stuff. People poured in the money. The bubble burst. All the money vanished. Millions and billions of dollars down the drain. Why? Poor in social psychology. Don't know how the society is reacting. Very important. These are all entrepreneurship, accounting, social psychology, or rather psychology, because psychology is a vast area. Social psychology is a sub-branch. Very, very important subjects. Please don't underestimate the value of these subjects. Yeah. So please, though the subjects seem, maybe a little dry, the applications are fantastic in the business world. Moving on, technology. Again, a very vast field. I cannot give justice to this, but I will try to contextualize. How does technology impact, commerce students? So I'll try to, box it into a smaller box, because technology, massive area. We are seeing trends where, coding is becoming easier and easier. At our time, we had COBOL, BASIC, VBA. Difficult to understand. Can't know what to do. How to write the code. Now Python has come in. Python, like Excel formulas, new people coming into the market, they are challenging us oldies, saying, we know Python, we know coding, we know how to automate. Do you know? We have to learn. We have to, you know, be students. We cannot be professionals. Once we say that, okay, we have the degree, now our life is made. Gone are the days, because the change is tremendous. You have to, you know, put on your student hat and learn what is Python. It is not some kind of an animal. It is a programming language. So you start with that, actually. Of course, I cannot learn coding, and rather it is not the right point of entry for me. But for y'all, it is a very fertile field. So RPA, robotic process automation. You know process, you know automation. We are talking about robotics. All three put together, it's not robots, but it's talking about automated accounting, automated bill passing. Many of y'all will be thinking, I'll do BCom. Yeah, BCom is not enough. Let me tell you very clearly, because more and more RPAs come in, the entry level jobs are drying up. Automation, entry level jobs, nowhere. Professionals, they want them. Why? Because they have the power of knowledge. So please be ambitious. Yeah, don't set your sights only to BCom, you know, only to graduation. Do whatever you want, but do a one step further, because at entry level you all should not struggle. Yeah, why is professional degree important? You should have foot in the door. Thousands and thousands of applications and jobs are few, so it's a competitive market. Use the technology mega trend for beating the competition. I may sound a little serious, but yeah, take it lightly. You all have one thing that I don't have, which you all have, is a lot of time. But utilize the time correctly. This is what I want to say. I'll go to the next slide. Is this okay? Anybody of you all can give me an input, because I cannot see your faces. Yeah, I'm just staring at my screen.
Chavi, would you like to speak? Chavi is there in the classroom.
Yes, sir. So the insight was really good, and we realized that not only as students, but as we grow, how important news regarding the business world becomes important to us, and how we can adapt to the changes that happen in the business environment as well by using such insights.
Very good. So that is what I would like to even touch upon. See, why I did this? Yeah, because the real world is multidimensional. Here we have put it neatly in boxes, but multidimensional articles are multidimensional. Problems are multidimensional. Roles are multidimensional. Yeah. So if there is an article on economics, it impacts business acumen, business environment, government policy, even more. Yeah. When I say I am a professional, it does not mean that I am only a professional. Sometimes I am demanded to think like an entrepreneur, though I am in corporate. Entrepreneurship skills are required in corporate. Don't think that entrepreneur means only starting your own business. More and more companies value entrepreneurship in corporate. Yeah. Students, professionals are students for life. Otherwise, they cannot continue them and tell that we are professionals, because they get outdated. So you have to learn. You have to learn new things. Market is changing. Technology is changing. Ways of doing business is changing. If you don't learn, you become redundant. So that is the fact of life. Yeah. So multidimensional, as well as the roles are also, it's not that you are only a student. In certain contexts, you all are professionals. In certain contexts, you all are entrepreneurs. In certain contexts, you use psychology. You use technology. You all are impacted by government policy. So everybody is impacted by everything. Yeah. Okay. So moving on. So it's a lighter slide. Yeah, this is just a reinforcement of what I was talking about earlier. So here I talked about the mega trend, China's behavior, systemic challenge, NATO talks tough. Now, see the shift in mega trend. NATO was an organization to protect Europe against USSR. USSR disintegrated, became Russia. Russia is not as powerful as it was when it was USSR. Now, which is the powerful country? China. So what do they say? China's behavior, systemic challenge. NATO talks tough. See the shift in mega trend. There was a mega trend after Cold War, which was there from 1945 to 1990 to 1995. Now, the new mega trend started from, say, 2008, because there was a recession, massive recession. Yeah, all the countries had a lot of pain. China still grew. Yeah, now China talks tough to NATO countries. Yeah, this is one mega trend. The other thing, TCS. Now, what does the chairman of TCS say? 3,000% return I have given. My company has delivered 3,000% return. So in 2004 IPO, if you would have invested 1 rupee, now that is 3,000 rupees. 3,000% return. Can you get it? It is once in a lifetime opportunity. I was there in 2004. I knew the IPO is coming. I thought, it's okay. I will ignore it. I will take it later. Later became 10 years, 15 years down the line. Okay, I didn't earn 3,000% return. Okay, I earned a handsome return, but not 3,000% return. Important part is not that we are talking about TCS of 2004. There may be budding TCS, lot of other companies today. Are you able to catch that company? When will you be able to catch? If you read the business newspaper, if you read the linkages to the business newspaper, it is not only business newspaper. Yeah. Further, I will tell in the next slides. Next is, there is a stock analyst of opinion, Bajaj Finance, recovery signs not convincing enough. Yeah, this is an article by one person. Yeah, he will give this article based on whatever is this, his facts, figures, interviews, information. Yeah, but can you take an investment decision based on just a stock analyst opinion? You cannot take any opinion on face value. Why? I will explain later. But important point, important takeaway is, don't take any opinion on face value. Go into depth, and that is a skill which you learn over a period of time. It cannot come from day one. Yeah, there are innumerable examples which I can give where, you know, stock analyst has written off the stock. This stock is not going to give money. But over a period of years, we have seen that it has doubled, tripled. Yeah. Sometimes people overreact on certain, companies. Management is a failure. Business environment is not good. You know, cost ratios are not proper. But these are driven by people. Environment changes, management changes. Yeah. Ways of doing business changes, technology changes. So there is nothing, no finality in any opinion. Yeah. So you always have to be tuned in whether this opinion is correct or not. That is how you read the paper. Yeah, this is a classic article. Whenever it comes to economics, it has got massive impact on almost everything. Economics, very important subject. Yeah, we are talking about retail inflation jumps to 6 month high of 6.3%. Okay, now you see the impacts. Okay. Inflation, always the RBI governor is worried about inflation because his main mandate is how does he control inflation. He is not worried about anything else than more than inflation. Once the inflation is increasing, there is very high pressure on him. Why? Inflation impacts the weakest section of the society. Yeah, the moment inflation increases, he is not in a position to reduce the interest rate. He cannot reduce the interest rate because He is, after all, a government agency. He is answerable to the government. Government is linked to politics, democracy. Government is worried whether I will get the votes or not of the weaker section of the people. On the one side, there is inflation. The other side, I have to see if employment I have to increase. If I increase the when the inflation is higher, and if I increase the interest rate, the weaker sections will suffer. They will come on the streets. They will protest. Opposition will take their hand and say this government is not for the weaker section. Votes will go to the opposition. Government will call the RBI. They will say, what you are doing? I do not care. Reduce the you increase the interest rate. I want inflation under control. So multidimensional. What is it impacting? Corporates, they always have an eye on the interest rate cycle. Why? Cascading impact. And don't think that interest rate is a simple tool. Huh? It is a deceptive tool. 2008 recession. Why it happened? You increase the interest rate. Rather, Alan Greenspan, Fed chairman, increase the interest rate 4, 5, 6 times within a very short span. Huge impact on the housing market. The housing market bubble burst. Millions of jobs dried up. Lehman went bankrupt. Yeah. So massive impact when the interest rate shifts. Now I can tell you today, the interest rate is going to shift. When it will shift, I don't know. But when it shifts, there will be massive outflow from the stock market. The stock market will fall. But it will come up again, but it will fall. When it will fall, nobody knows. It is only a guessing game. A lot of economists will tell you it will fall 3 months, 6 months. Some stock analysts say it will happen end of the year, beginning of the year. Nobody knows. But when it happens, there will be a shock in the system. Children, sometimes I will just, kind of deviate and go into too much depth. Huh? So you all have to in between interrupt me and tell, sir, you are taking a lot of time. Okay, so here is the overview of the newspaper of Business Standard. So we come down to, the how part of it. Now, the important part was the why. Yeah, if you all are convinced on the why, you all will do whatever is needed to inculcate this habit. If you are not convinced on the why, how much I tell about the how, you all will not be convinced. Okay, so how part is easier, why part I had to take time. Yeah. So here in the Business Standard, you can see the page headings. We are talking about headlines. We are talking about, So overall, if you see, this is just an indicative thing. Price is 10 rupees. Pages range from, say, 14 to 16. Maybe I can just, put the pointer. So price is 10 rupees. Pages 14 to 16. Yeah. Page headings, we have headlines, then we have got company news, then we have got economy and public affairs. This I have already touched upon a little. Take two, more to do with opinions by eminent journalists, people who, knowledgeable people, senior people, industry leaders. World, what is happening in the world economy, world business, opinion. So here, opinions will be into two parts. One is editorial. What is editorial? Business Standard will give an opinion on the government policy, whether the government is doing correct, whether the government should have done this, whether RBI should have taken this stand, whether the opposition is responsible enough. So all kinds of opinions are given. That you should read. It will broaden your thinking. Then there is other set of opinions given by senior journalists on various affairs. Yeah. Then the smart investor. This is more to do with stock market, investing, personal finance, all kinds of stuff. Stocks. This is more to do with in-depth individual stocks, whether the company is going doing good, whether the industry is good, whether it is technically strong, whether fundamentals are okay. So those stuff is covered here. Politics and public affairs, this I don't have to tell you. Advertisement and notices, tenders. Governments, they have to give tenders to various infrastructure projects. Contractors bid. So this is a business opportunity for contractors. They have to read the business paper, take the cutout of the tender, apply for it, see if they are the lowest bidder, and the government will provide them the contracts. Personal finance, financial planning. my child is going for an MBA. 4 years down the line, 15 lakh rupees I have to save. I have to plan right now, or I must have planned about 3 years back, so that at that time, when my child says that I want to go for an MBA, I have cleared my IIM, I should be able to provide the money. How do I plan for it? Personal finance, technology, we have touched upon it. Take two, again, it is just same opinions. Yeah. Last page, it's all generic stuff. Usually you will see in the last page, all kinds of stuff will be there. It will not only be, about finance or business, maybe even general stuff will be there. Then Smart Investor is a special supplement specifically for, stock market investing. So you will have all kinds of indices. You will see the NSE, BSE, options, all kinds of stuff will be there. So this is specifically for stock market. So this is the overview. Why I have given this is so that when you all read the paper, you all will know how is the information flow. Why we need this? Because we have got only 15 minutes. We don't have the, because we are not retired people where we can sit in the morning and still until the evening we can read the paper. We have only 15 minutes to read, maximum 20 minutes. Within that 20 minutes, we have to read what we want and then we shelf the newspaper. Later on, you can give it to Raddiwala. You can recover some money out of it. Now we come to the next part, which is how do we read a business newspaper? Now there are some pointers. Some I will explain, some I can, just skip. So browse the headlines on each page. Very simple, no explanation required. Start reading the details. If the headline tag is, headline oblique tagline is interesting. Very important. You don't have to read everything. Headline should be interesting for you. Otherwise, why will you read? If you are not able to understand fully the headline, see the tagline. Tagline is what? A single liner just below the headline. Whether it is interesting? Yes, it is interesting. Then you go into the article. Whether the article is interesting? First para read, I am not very satisfied. Skip the other para. Skip the third para. Skip the fourth para. Read the fifth para. So that is paragraph skipping technique. Why you want it? Because you don't have to read it as a novel or as a textbook. You just want the key information out of that article. You don't have time. You don't have time to read it for. So if the article is half a page of a newspaper, you don't have half an hour to read it. You have to read the key information and move ahead. So that is paragraph skipping technique. In case of opinion, if the headline is not clear and the article is lengthy, read the bottom most, the concluding para. From the concluding para, you know whether you want to read the article or not. If the conclusion is not interesting, it is hazy, maybe you say that, okay, I'll skip it. Watch out for mega trends. Those will help you both personally and professionally. Very, very important. If your mind has wandered, please come back. Watch out for mega trends. Yeah, I have talked enough on that, but it is not enough because it's a very big topic. But you all have understood what is a mega trend. Yeah, so build on it. Do not believe everything that is printed. This we already, I have explained. So human beings, we all are human beings. We make mistakes. Sometimes we feel that something is glittering, it is a diamond, but maybe it is a glass. So we sometimes have that cognitive issues. Yeah, so everybody is human, everybody can make mistakes, even if it's the best of intention. So you read paper with that in mind. Yeah, read the editorials, it will broaden your thinking. This I have already touched upon. Search on Google for financial terms. This is more for you students, so that some of the financial terms are you are reading for the first time. Go to Google, your knowledge will increase. Find dictionary meaning of English. Very obvious, you don't need a dictionary now, just type in Google, you'll get the meaning. Consider newspaper reading as fun activity. Do not take the task very seriously. I may sound very serious, but this activity is fun. Please do not take the task seriously. It is fun. In your age, you all should have fun. If fun is not there, then in which age will you have fun? Yeah. So it should be fun. So then the habit should grow on you. So there is no enforcement. Yeah. You enjoy the activity, you continue. You don't enjoy the activity, please do not buy the paper and tax yourself. Yeah. The habit will grow. That I will explain to you in the next slides. Graduate from general newspaper to business newspaper. This is just an indication. It is not a constraint. people usually graduate from Indian Express to Times to Hindu to Economic Times to Business Standard. Yeah, that is generally that path, because at every level, even the newspaper becomes costlier and the English also is tougher. Consider this as a general rule, not a constraint. Consider expense on a business newspaper as an investment, not an expense. Very, very important. Yeah. Most of the time, what we think, okay, 10 rupees, 50 rupees in a week, 250 rupees a month. Yeah. 2,500 rupees sir, for 10 months, 3,000 rupees for a year. Why should I spend it? Two pizzas, large pizzas, two McDonald's trips. One full year newspaper expense gone. Yeah. In enjoying. Yeah. So think about it. Newspaper for one full year, giving to Raddiwala, receiving some money out of it, getting a lot of knowledge and awareness, as against two trips to McDonald's, true home delivery of pizza, which is more beneficial. Yeah, so thought for reflection. So here I am talking about my personal journey when it comes to business newspaper reading. Yeah, I'll touch upon, 1995, first time saw Economic Times paper during articleship. So I am talking about in BCom. Huh? So before that, I didn't know what is a business newspaper. I always read general newspaper. So general newspaper reading from an early age, business newspaper didn't know what it was. So my boss was a keen follower of stock market. He used to insist, please read, we were articles. So we were kind of happy-go-lucky at that time. We used to listen to him and then we used to forget. Yeah. So 96 to 99, occasionally read Economic Times, started understanding the paper better. Yeah. So you can see that I am not very serious. 96 to 99, okay, sometimes I read, sometimes I forget. Yeah. 2001, interviews, general knowledge questions, asking about business awareness. So in the interviews, they will ask about business awareness. Then I will think, yeah, there was something that was there, So what is DAX? What is Nifty? What is, okay, I have read somewhere, I've seen somewhere, but okay, I may not be able to answer the full question. But still, I have not inculcated the habit. 2002 to 2004, here is where then I started to subscribe to Economic Times on a daily basis. So here you can see the fun element should be there. You all should not force yourself to reading a paper on day one, because the habit should grow and it should be fun. Then only it is sustainable. To be sustainable, you should feel that, okay, it is a fun activity. Just let's invest some 10, 15 minutes. Something will come out of it. Yeah. Connect dots across pages and across dates if you want to make money on the stock market. Very good advice from my manager. Yeah. He was again too deep into stock market. He used to say, Milind, I can connect across pages, across editions, across books. And I know where to invest. I know what is the trend. I do not ask financial advisors for advice, because I know where to invest and I know how to make money. How does he know? Over a period of years, he has developed the skill. Such kind of skills cannot be taught in a classroom. Such skills are learned by trial and error. Very important to make mistakes. Learn, again make mistakes. New mistakes are not the old ones. Continue reading Economic Times. Would occasionally read other business magazines. So now I am branching out. Yeah, from of course, occasionally I used to read earlier also, but I am branching out to other magazines: Business World, Harvard, Business Review, Economist, Wealth Insight. Why Wealth Insight? So personally, I feel it's a very good publication for stock market. Yeah, because they talk about fundamentals. They talk about clear-cut, stock market models are there. So they don't give too much of their opinion. They go by quantitative analysis and whether, the financial statements are transparent, whether the company is making profit. So they don't get swayed by market sentiment. So that is what I like about it. So Wealth Insight is a good magazine. You all can, look at it. Switch from Economic Times to Business Standard. Continue to read Business Standard at least for 5 to 20 minutes on a daily basis. So I am a family man, responsibilities, kids to take care of, professional life, limited social life, limited time for hobbies. So in that, I have to find 5 to 20 minutes. I try to find it. Sometimes wife is little irritated, saying that this guy is not giving time to the family and is coolly sitting and reading paper while I'm cooking. So all the kind of stuff. But you need this. Yeah. Okay, what you students can do to embark on this journey? I think I've taken a lot of time when we started. Okay, it's almost hour. Huh? Okay, so divide the students to 6 groups. I think this all you have done. This why we are doing is best way of retaining whatever I have said is doing. Yeah, listening, looking at the slides, after a week you will forget. But if you start doing, if you start reading, then only you'll get the benefit of this. Whatever 1 hour of your lifetime I have taken, the benefit will only come when you start subscribing and reading the paper. Otherwise, memory is short. 2 weeks, okay, he has given a good kind of something, he has said it's very good. But after 1 month, everything is forgotten. Yeah. So learning by doing is what will give results. So scan the newspaper. Discuss amongst yourself in the group, present one news item from the paper and present to the Commerce Club. Yeah, and then best presentation among the 6 group will get a certificate. Why certificate is only to motivate you all. Yeah, it's a tough thing to start with any new habit. Yeah, but again, my humble request, take it as a fun activity, grow into the habit. There is nothing wrong that after 30 days you say that, okay, this is too technical for me, I will revisit it. But please do revisit. As soon as your knowledge is to a certain level, you all can do. Some of you all are, amongst you all, maybe quite bright. Yeah, I cannot underestimate the younger generation. You people will be seeing this old man is talking about, again and again, whether we can do it. You can do it. Yeah, start early, you all will be ahead. So yeah, so that is the end of my talk. Yeah. Thanks for your time. If you all have any questions, you can pose it to me. Hello. I hope everybody is awake and you all have survived my talk. Yeah, so some reactions. Yeah, anybody can talk, no problem.
I want to say that, like the point you said where you have to like find the fun in it, because only then will it become a habit. I found that very useful for me, because when I try to read it, I just do it like a chore and I get bored of it and I get annoyed. So if I try to just figure out some way to keep me interested, that would help me better. So I think that was a good point, sir.
Yeah, thanks. Actually, it's a very important point also. You saw my personal journey, right? You saw how it, So at the end of the slide, actually, I missed one point. There is a point for reflection. Reflection is what, you people are starting with your career. Okay. When you saw that slide, you saw my canvas, of 20 years. Yeah. But you all are starting. Just visualize what it will be 20 years hence. How do you want your canvas to be? Yeah, I'm sure that everybody, each one of you all, can start with this habit much earlier than what I have started with. It will pay you dividends. Yeah, any other question? Fine, I hope this was interesting for you all. Okay, so I will not take more time because I have already overshot, I told you that once I start, I may not be able to stop. So yeah, thanks for your time. Over to you all.
Thank you, sir. I would like to invite Tarun for the vote of thanks. Tarun, over to you.
Thank you, Suraj. A warm and a cherished morning to our most valued guest, Mr. Milind Nayar, for equipping us with informative tools to comprehend business newspapers. Thank you, sir. We will definitely instill the habits of reading newspapers, absorbing business acumen. I definitely agree. Going to the corporate world needs a lot of business acumen, and we being the future human resource needs to start early for having a competitive edge. The article that you have shown us talking about the mega trends was insightful and gave us a very good information about multidimensional impact on various sectors. The paragraph skipping technique is an interesting manner to utilize the time and stick to keyword information while reading the paper. We assure you that we will start as early as tomorrow. On behalf of Samhita Academy, I also intend to thank Jyoti ma'am for taking out her valuable time and addressing the grade 12 and 11 with her encouraging words. It is my privilege to propose a vote of thanks. The insights that Milind sir has provided us today surely go a long way in helping us learn how to read a business newspaper. Sir, I, on behalf of the students, assure that we will pick up on these guidelines you have provided us. I would like to thank our principal and teachers who were able to arrange this extracurricular activity that broke the monotonous routine. Once again, I thank everyone present here today. Have a good day.
Thank you and all the best.
So all the students are requested to fill a feedback form. I'll put it in the chat box. It's compulsory to fill it. So also put your mention your name and class.
Also, you know, children, we'll take a 15 minutes break, huh? Before we go to the next class. So we just finished now. It is 10:30. So next class, you can join 10:45. Okay. Both 11C and 12B. Okay. So was it okay? Did you all enjoy the session? Lot of takeaways. Yeah. Now we'll work on it. Now he's asked us to create those six groups. Yeah, we will work on it. We'll try reading slowly. We'll see how much we understand. Yeah. So whatever sections you are divided into, we'll try working as a group, working as a team, and Sugata ma'am will keep you posted the timelines when we will have time to present the same. Okay. So wonderful team, good effort, okay? Good teamwork by the entire class, okay? Thank you, children. Have a nice day. And please fill up the form which Vidula is talking about. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
And thank you, ma'am.
I would like to appreciate all the efforts by the students right from starting to the end. So it's a very great initiative from all the students and all the supporting people who have contributed for this. Thank you all. Nice.
Thank you, children. You rocked the event. That was first event, first break, and we'll be back.